Hello dear students, I'm Dr. Chandrakala HT. In this video, under the network layer topic, I'll be teaching you the datagrams approach and the features of datagram networks. First of all, let's understand what do we mean by datagrams. So in a connectionless communication system, datagram means the smallest unit of data which can be transmitted over the network. Datagrams are data packets which contain adequate header information so that they can be routed individually by the intermediate network switching devices or routers so that the packets will reach the destination. Since communication occurs through datagrams, these networks are called as datagram networks. Datagrams exist in packet switching networks. Now to the features of datagram networks. Datagram switching happens in the network layer of the communication system. In datagram networks, each data packet is called as datagram and it can be routed independently from source to destination node, even if they belong to the same message. So here, a single message is divided into datagrams and each datagram will be transmitted individually on different paths. So all the packets of a single message will not travel on the same path. Each packet of the message will follow different paths. Each datagram will be treated as an independent unit on the network, on the datagram network, as there is no fixed dedicated path for data transfer in these networks. In datagram network, each datagram will be routed by the intermediate routers using their dynamically changing routing table. So the routing table, it's a piece of data structure which contains the information about the next available communication path connected to that particular node. So this will be dynamically changing depending on the network load or network traffic on those communication channels. When a node receives a datagram, it will check its routing table through its router, and whichever route is free is indicated in the routing table dynamically, and that particular route will be taken up by the packet and it will be sent to the next level. So two consecutive or successive packets from the source may follow completely two separate routes to reach the destination in case of datagram networks. And one more feature of datagram network is no prior resource allocation will be made for any individual packets in these networks. When we say resources, they are nothing but the buffers, processors, the network bandwidth, etc. So these are never reserved before the communication starts. So in datagram networks, the resources will be allocated on a first come first serve basis. When a packet arrives at the router, it must wait if any other packets are being processed by it currently, irrespective of its source or destination. It doesn't have any special provisions or priorities. So depending on the order in which it arrives, it has to wait till its turn comes on the router and then it will get processed. So data communication is generally, it's guided by the user datagram protocol or UDP, which operates on the transport layer. So UDP will assist this datagram communication. So UDP, as we all know, is a connectionless protocol, and datagram networks are also connectionless networks. They never have a dedicated path of communication between two nodes. So randomly, whichever path is available between the source to destination through intermediate nodes, that will be taken up by a path. And the availability of these paths will dynamically keep changing in the network depending on the network data traffic. So this diagram shows how the datagram packets will be routed between one host to another on a datagram network. So assume host one is sending a message which is divided into four packets, A, B, C, D. So this message which contains these four individual packets, you can observe each datagram packet is taking a different route to reach the host 2, which is the destination. So A is following a different path, B is following a different path, C is following a different path, D is following a different path. But finally, all the four packets of the message will reach host 2. And naturally, these packets will not arrive in order because datagram networks do not have a connection-oriented path between the source and destination. Since it's connectionless, the packet delivery will be out of order. Host 2 should take up the responsibility of rearranging the packets in the correct order. So each packet will have some sequence number which will help the host 2 in order to rearrange the packets so that it will understand the message in the right order. So in this video, you learned the datagrams approach and the features of data networks, datagram networks, which operate in the network layer level of the OSI model. Thank you.